Dear students, today we will discuss some programs of Python. So first of all, you should know that Python has two interfaces. One is the interactive interface where you just type the command and you will get the result. So this is the prompt of Python, and here you whatever you type, it will give you the result instantly. For example, in the lists, we are creating a list L is equal to, these are the members of the list, 1, 3. Okay. Just put the numbers in square brackets and press enter. Now you are having list L. And if you want to see this list, just type print L. It will show you list. Now, so this is not a program of Python. So program of Python is not written here. In this command prompt, you just type the different statements or type different commands and you will get a result instantly. So if you want to add another member to this list, you can do it like this, L.append 5 and press enter. So now again print L to see what is list L. So this is 1, 3, 5. So append method is used to add a member to the list. If you want to another method, again L dot append 100, press enter. If you want to see print L, and you will get the list. So list is 1, 3, 5, 100. In this way you can add more members to a list. So there are different methods which can be used to add members to the list, but this is not the program. To write a program, you have to go to the file, then press new file, and you will get this window, and just you type the program here. For example, program to add 5 numbers. To see, you want to add any 5 numbers, so for that you have to write a simple program is so just type numbers A is equal to 10, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 4, D is equal to 1, E is equal to 7. So these are the numbers, and if we want to perform the addition of these numbers, so take another variable, S is equal to A plus B plus C plus D plus E, and print S. So this is a program, this is a full-fledged program of Python to add 5 numbers. So before running this program, file, save. You have to save this file, give it name as addition. Python file means .py, so py is the extension. So save this program and go to the run and run module F5. So you will get result here. This is 24 is the result, addition of all the 5 numbers. So in this way you can find the result. If you want to print message with this, just give a message addition of 5 numbers is equal to comma s. So again file and save file. You can also press control s, then run and run module. So now the result is addition of 5 numbers is equal to 24. So this message has also been printed with this result. So this is the way to write a program. So you must know the difference between the command prompt and the program. So there are two interfaces. One is by using the command prompt, second is by writing the program. Now if you want to create the list, so I'm going to save this program as save as list program bana dene assi. So it is list, and now I want to create a list, say I name it as number. Numbers the list 1, 5, 0, 4, 20. So this is a list. I have created a list named number. So this is a list whose name is number. If you want to print this list, so write print number. So it will print the list. So I stop this here, file, save, then run module. So this is the execution of that program. This you can see the result. It has printed the list. So this is the list 150. Program is the instructions given in the program is to just to create this list and print this list by using print function. Now if we want to add the number to this list, some more numbers, you can write number dot add number dot append method use karna and give the number. Suppose we want to 100. Okay, so now again we print the list, print number. So save the program, then run the program. You will see this is the first list without adding a number. This is second list when we have added a number to the list. So this is the way to add numbers to a list. So next is file save as. In 4 file de vich save kar rahe hain, save as max. So maximum, we want to find the maximum of a number, maximum from the list. Program to find maximum you can say largest number from the list. So first of all I create a list, say name of the list is L is equal to 3, 56, 1, 80, -9, -3. So this is a list, and we want to find the maximum number. So write max or bigger number, you can say big is equal to L 0. First number, L0 stands for the first number in the list. So we have put the first number in this list. Then we will use for loop for I in L. L is list and I is any variable. For I in a list L, we will check if I is greater than big. If it is greater than big, then big should be equal to I. Big is equal to I. So this process continue for the whole loop. I starting from I moves in the list. The value of I in the first pass will be 3, in the second pass will be 56, then 1, then 80, then minus 9, then minus 3. So it will find the maximum value or biggest value. So when we exit from the list, so in the next statement you have to print it. Print largest value is equal to comma big. So this is the program for finding the largest number from the list. So save this program, then run. So this is the syntax error. Agar we find some error, we have to rectify it. File open, name is max. So there must be colon at the end of for or end of the if. Just save, then run module. So largest value is 80. You can also see in the list largest value is 80. So this is program to find the largest number from the list. Similarly, you can modify this program, save as largest and smallest. Large and small. So you are going to find both number. To find the largest and smallest number from the list. So I am going to increase this list 45, then minus 12, then 1043, and this program will move like this. Big is equal to L0, and I also take another number. Small is equal to L0, list 0. So first element, I put first element of the list in big as well as in small. And if I is greater than big, then big is equal to I. And I will check for another if I is less than small, then small is equal to I. And in printing we will write two statement, largest value is and smallest value is. So this is for smallest value. Smallest value is equal to this small. So this is the program for finding largest and smallest value. So I'm going to run this program. run. So you can see that largest value is 1043 and smallest value is -12. You can see in the list also, this is the list and it contains the largest value 1043 and smallest value -12. So this is a very simple program. In we have taken a list named L, and then we have taken two variables. One is named big and another is named small. You can give them any valid variable names, so that's not a problem. You can write also here B, and for small you can write here S. It will also run in the similar way. And we have given the first element of the list to big and small. Then we have checked all the elements by using this for loop. We have checked all the elements. If some element is greater than big, bigger value which we have stored in big, if some value in this list is bigger than that value, we give to the big variable that value. And similarly, if what we have given to the small variable, if there is some value which is smaller than that value, we assign that to the small. So largest value and smallest value both are printed. So these are some of the programs to illustrate the use of lists in Python.